Hello everyone, welcome to this week's episode of Pie in the Sky. There are a lot of things to get to in this episode, and I don't want you to miss one important step. So without further ado, it's off to the kitchen. First up is our pizza. We're going to go from sauce to slice and bring an absolutely delicious, beautiful pie to our guest. To make the sauce, I only use 1/6 ounce can of tomato paste, 1 cup of water, a spoon, a can opener, and a bowl to mix it in. If you start out with too much water in your heavy pizza sauce, it won't be heavy anymore. If you're trying to get a thin pizza sauce, what you should try doing is applying a lesser amount to the same diameter of pizza shell. After you spread it out over the entire surface, the result will be a lightly sauced pizza. Now I prefer to make my own heavy pizza sauce. It's just important to me that everything involved from beginning to end be my own creation, so that when it does come out of the oven, I'm completely responsible, good or bad, for what my guests are enjoying or not enjoying. You want to give your sauce a good stir before applying, and then if you're having a lightly sauced pizza, you use a lesser amount. This pizza is normally sauced, so I'm going to be doing it with a larger amount, spreading it from the center out towards the edges, being sure to cover the entire surface so that each piece of the crust gets a bite of sauce. I'm going to start out by applying a base coat or a primer coat of some Parmigiano Reggiano. This will keep the toppings from sliding off when I cut it. And it's also going to add an extra layer of flavor right next to the sauce, just enough saltiness to the tanginess. After I apply the primer coat of cheese, I'm going to put on a small amount of my chosen topping, which today is Canadian bacon. As I mentioned before, after the first layer of toppings goes on, I'm going to take and place the largest amount of my cheese over that. Now, when you're just starting out, I believe that shredded mozzarella in the bag, which you can get in any grocery store, is probably your best choice. This is for 3 reasons. 1, it's going to keep your prep time down. 2, it's going to keep your cleanup time down. And 3, and most importantly, it's not going to cut into your wallet with food cost. Then, once you get the basic structure of your recipe down, you can start experimenting with different varieties of cheese in combination with different toppings. Each one will produce a different end flavor, and you can find out exactly what you want to make your perfect pie taste like. Of course, this is, as I said, shredded mozzarella. I've also mixed in an amount of fontina. Next, I'm going to come back in with my topping and place the final layer of the ham over the top of my cheese. Now, when I speak of layers, I'm not only talking about one application of each topping after the other, I'm also talking about flavor. As you bite through the finished product and chew it, you're going to notice that each bite reveals a different characteristic within the pie. Now, after I put on my first layer of toppings, I like to cover the rest of the pizza with my largest amount of cheese. This will help control the moisture release, as well as retain enough moisture to make the inner part of the crust turn out snappy and happy. Alright, our pizzas are ready to go into the oven. We're going to be cooking them at 475 degrees in a preheated oven. Now, a lot of people don't know what preheating means, so I'll tell you. Preheating simply means that you're going to bring an oven up to the cooking temperature before you put your pizza in. You do this by turning the thermostat on to 475 and then waiting for the oven cycle light to go off, and you're ready to rock and roll.
Now bear in mind as you put this into the oven, Your pizza's crust is what's going to determine the amount of baking time. For a thin crust, you need to go about 6 minutes or until the outside edge turns golden brown, and for a thick crust, that's right, 8 minutes later and this bad boy is ready to come out of the oven. Let's take a look at it first. Oh man, that is a hot looking pie. And speaking of hot pies, that is the best time to cut your pizza, is when it's just out of the oven and looking fine. Now you'll notice that I'm cutting this into strips and then eventually into squares. This is known as an old school cut or a Sicilian cut. Now, two things can be accomplished by this. One, it's easier to handle for kids, and that's going to make it easier on you at the end of the day because you won't be picking it up off the floor. And two, it looks great on a plate. And here it is, the hottest looking pizza in town. Baby, you look fine. All right, that's all the time we've got for this episode of Pie in the Sky, and it marks the end of our instructional series. From now on, we're going to be baking our pies together, and as we wait for them to cook, I'm going to go out and do interviews with artists, as well as other pizzaiola in the area. I'd like to thank all my great viewers for tuning in and sending in those great questions and comments to the comments section of the Coldhitz channel, Coldhitz at youtube.com. Also, don't forget to tune in for the pie vlog this week. And I guess that's all there is. Goodbye!